There's growing concern among business owners tonight that they might be cut off from any government help when the JobKeeper scheme changes in September. Many fear the rules will be too strict and they'll be forced to lay off staff.
The cost of fighting the pandemic will deliver taxpayers a bill that will have to be paid for generations.
This debt burden's going to be with you, with me, with our children for in the years ahead.
The budget deficit will explode to an historic high of $185 billion this financial year as gross debt blows out to $852 billion.
What else could have we done except spend through this crisis?
To try and rein in that spending, the government will begin winding back unemployment benefits and wage subsidies from September.
We want businesses to be able to graduate out of JobKeeper. That's the point, not for them to remain permanently dependent on JobKeeper.
With tougher eligibility tests on the way, some small business owners like martial arts trainer Tom Adam worry about the added complexity.
I'm really kind of looking at whether I just cut off completely or just avoid trying to go through the stress of the paperwork to satisfy the government.
To keep JobKeeper payments beyond September, businesses will have to show their turnover has fallen by at least 30% in the June and September quarters. And advocates say the brief reopening in Victoria might count against those now forced back into lockdown.
Well, if that isn't fine-tuned, then come the December quarter, it'll be lots of businesses just have to put the staff off.
The recession spawned by the health crisis has a long way yet to run, and if high unemployment persists, that will become a serious problem for the government.
This government likes slogans. JobKeeper, job seeker, job trainer. What we actually need is job creator from this government.
And that is a job for the Treasurer. Chris Yulman, Nine News.